In this video, we are going to be assessing muscular fitness.
Muscular fitness composed of muscular strength, muscular endurance, and bone strength.
With stable muscular fitness, you can lower the chance of developing lower back problems.
Osteoporosis, which is brittle and weak bones.
And musculoskeletal injuries that refers to damage to your bones or muscles.
So how are we going to assess muscular fitness?
We are going to be doing the push-up test.
What he said. The results of this push-up test is going to determine whether our client's muscular fitness is excellent, good, or needs improvement.
This can be determined by using the norms on this chart.
So to start the push-up test, you want to have your client in this position with their toes on the mat and their hands under their shoulders. So from this position, the client will fully extend his elbows and come up to this push-up position. For males, when they come up and fully extend their elbows, they'll be using their toes as their pivot point. So for females, when they come up and fully extend their elbows, they're going to use their knees as their pivot point rather than their toes, like this. So when the client is up in this position, his upper back will be in a straight line and his head up, facing straight ahead. And then as he begins to go down on the push-up, his chin will touch the mat before he comes up again and fully extends his elbows, the whole time keeping his upper back in a straight line and his head up. So for the female push-up, still using her knees as a pivot point.
Are we finished yet? I have a hair appointment in 15 minutes. Gosh!
You look like you need it.
Oh, okay.
Still using her knees as a pivot point, she's going to keep her back completely straight and chin up, looking ahead. Then she's going to go down, chin touching the mat, come back up, fully extend her elbows, keeping her back straight the entire time and her head up. So as your client comes down, his stomach and thighs should not touch the mat as so, and then come back up. For the push-up test, your clients will perform as many consecutive push-ups as they can with no break in between each push-up and with no time limit. Ready? Go. If you see one of your clients forcibly straining to do their next push-up, like she is right now, you're going to terminate their test. Sorry, ma'am, I'm going to have to terminate your test. That's where you'll stop counting.
Not fair!
So let's analyze these results.
I'm 24 years old, and I did 40 push-ups. That means I have excellent muscular fitness.
Well, I'm 21 years old, and since the examiner was cheating, I only did 2 push-ups, and apparently my muscular fitness needs a lot of improvement. You know what? I'm out of here. I need to go to my hair appointment anyways.